Okay, this is just going to be hopefully a short video on how to recognize when a Bible translation you're reading is wrong. Basically, the first thing you really need to do is keep using 1 John 1:9 like breathing. Because when you're reading, the Holy Spirit will alert you to a passage that in the translation you're reading is not right. And that's actually why I'm making this video. I've been doing a lot of research lately into Peter, Jude, and Book of Hebrews and the Gospel of Mark. And I was really tired and I thought, oh, I'm just going to sit down and read a translation. I didn't want to sit at the computer, so I grabbed the NIV Bible. And while I'm reading my hard copy of the NIV, I'm beginning to look at 1 Peter to try to get a sense of why he's writing what he's writing, because Bible always boggles my mind in translation. And as I'm reading, I'm looking at this, okay? Who have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father. Okay, no problem there. Watch this. Through the sanctifying work of the Spirit. Okay. Now watch. For obedience to Jesus Christ and sprinkling. Huh? Through the sanctifying work of God the Spirit, for, meaning the reason why, for obedience to Jesus Christ and sprinkling. Now come on, think about that. You've been chosen by the foreknowledge of God through the sanctifying of the Spirit for what? For obedience and sprinkling? And as soon as I read that, the alarm goes off in my head because I use 1 John 1:9 like breathing. And I'm like, the translation's wrong here. I can't be chosen by God in his foreknowledge, then sanctified by the Spirit for the purpose of obedience to Christ and sprinkling. How am I going to be sprinkling his blood? Right? It looks like it says I was chosen by God in order to obey Christ and sprinkle his blood? No. Okay. So right there, you know, bing, bing, bing. When you see weird words in what you're reading in the Bible, words you don't understand or don't make sense, if you're using 1 John 1:9, the Holy Spirit will help you understand those words. Or, as he did in my case, he will alert you to ding, 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 go look up the Greek. It's mistranslated. Okay? We'll do that again. See the weirdness of the wording. Who have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father. No problem there. Through the sanctifying work of the Spirit, no problem there. For what? Obedience to Jesus Christ in sprinkling? I don't think so. That can't be what Peter meant to write. You see why I say that? So let's look at what it means, okay? We'll just take this one because this one's just as bad as the rest of them. All right? See, Bible translators are in a hurry or it's a political correctness problem, and so they all just copy each other rather than, you know, fix it. This is why I'm so mad at so-called Christian scholars. They're playing political games, and the Word of God is a casualty. I'm sorry, you know, if I have a choice of being nasty by, you know, being nasty to the Word of God and just letting a mistake go, versus being nasty to some person who was lazy and didn't do his homework, guess what I'm going to pick? The Word of God is more important than people. We should be careful about being nasty to the Word of God, don't you think? And to hell with us as people. We all make mistakes, no big deal. All right, well, this is a whopper mistake. All right, let's first go through it. You know, by the foreknowledge of Father and the sanctifying work of the Holy Spirit. That's what all that says in Greek. Okay? Because I'm trying to keep this short. This is our problem here. eis hupakoin kai rantismon chaimatos. I'm not going to use the modern Greek pronunciation, sorry. Yesu Christu chariskoumi kai airene ple tun te. Okay? It is an American accent, I apologize. Here's our problem. Ice. See, they're translating this to obey. That's not what it says. Ice means to go into, to result from, or to result in. Okay? When it's used geographically, it means into, in, at, on, upon, by, near, among, against, or concerning. The figurative use is concerning, as, or with reference to, which is a very common thing in Peter. So this should be translated, okay, instead of to obey, with reference to. Peter uses it that way a lot in his letters. With reference to, or resulting in. Same idea. With reference to means that what's going to follow ice is the content of the purpose. In other words, see, here's the God's purposeful foreknowledge and the Holy Spirit's already sanctifying work. It's a done thing already. Okay, so now, why did they do it? Well, you can translate this with reference to explain why the foreknowledge, why the sanctifying work of the Spirit, or you can translate it with respect to a result of God's foreknowledge, a result of the sanctifying work of the Spirit. And given the way the Bible usually does things, it probably has both layers of meaning. Okay, and now let's walk through them so you can decide this for yourself. Use 1 John 1:9. Because God will witness to what I'm saying if it's true, and he'll tell you I'm a fool if it's not true. Okay, let's go. Ice, with reference to. So now we say, according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, by means of the sanctifying work of the Spirit, with reference to obedience, even, chi means even, the atoning work of the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, doesn't that make more sense? Sprinkling is the word here, literally, but it's a Hebraism. It means the sprinkling of the blood on top of the mercy seat under the law, which depicted the atoning work of Christ. Okay, literally you translate it sprinkling. But whose blood is it? The blood of Jesus Christ. That's haimatos. That means that's his blood. It's in the genitive. The sprinkling of the blood of who? The blood of Jesus Christ. That's also in the genitive. See? Rantismon, sprinkling. Haimatos, of the blood. Jesu Christu, of Jesus Christ. Oh. It's not my blood. I'm not sprinkling his blood. Okay? So, eis with reference to hupakoin, the obedience or the standing under, even, kai, the sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. In other words, Father's foreknowledge and the Spirit's sanctifying work is done what? With reference to obedience, even the sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. So whose obedience is it? Christ's. So whose blood is it? Christ's. It's not for us to obey Jesus Christ. It's his obedience. It's not that the Spirit and the Father are obeying Jesus Christ. It's his obedience. And all that is accomplished by a proper translation of this preposition, eis, which means with reference to, because of. That's another good translation. That's the way Paul uses it. But Peter likes to use with reference to. So let's do it again. All right? According to the foreknowledge of God the Father, by means of the sanctifying work of the Spirit, with reference to, because of, resulting in, resulting from, the obedience, even the sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, isn't that clearer? Let's do it again, because nobody translates it properly. This is a killer. When they get it wrong, they really get it wrong. Okay? Kata, according to, proegnosing, the foreknowledge, Deu, of God, Patros, Father, en, by means of, Hagiasmoi, the sanctifying work, Pneumatos, Holy Spirit, Eis, because of, with reference to, resulting in, resulting from, Hupakoin, the obedience, Kai, even, Rantismon, sprinkling, atoning, Chaimatos, blood of Jesus Christ. Now, do you see anybody on screen? These are all the major English translations. Do you see anybody on screen who realizes that the obedience here, first of all, it's a noun, not a verb, hupakoin. I mean, this comes from hupakuo. Okay, let's look at, see. It's a noun, not a verb. It's sometimes okay to translate it as a verb, but it's talking about whose obedience? With reference to the obedience, even the sprinkling of the blood of, that's whose obedience it is, of, that's whose blood it is, Jesus Christ. Unbelievable. You think, I mean, the NAU came out what? How many years ago? I mean, this is criminal, okay? 1995. This translation has been out for 20 years and they haven't fixed it. That's criminal. I'm sorry. Okay, KJV? Oh, it's not better. Look, unto obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. Is it clear to you that it's his obedience? No. It makes it look like that's what we're supposed to do. Yeah, as if you could do that unto the sprinkling of your own blood. I don't think so. But it's not quite as bad as here. So KJV is kind of better than the NAU. All right, let's try the next one. NIV, oh, totally confusing. Who have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father through the sanctifying work of the Spirit for obedience. No, not for. By means of might be okay. Because of would be better. Look how this sentence changes. Who have been chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father through the sanctifying work of the Spirit because of the obedience of Jesus Christ, not to. It just should be of. It's a genitive case, for crying out loud. This is genitive. Oh, man. See? Genitive means of, not to. Okay, and it's the ASV. Okay, this is basic Bible English. Made clean by his blood. Yeah, okay. Been made holy by the Spirit. Disciples made clean by his blood? No, that's not what the text says. It's true, but that's not what the text says. Okay, let's try the Douay Rheims. According to the foreknowledge of God the Father, according to the sanctification of the Spirit, unto obedience. They just copied the KJV. Okay. Actually, the Douay Rheims came out a year before, so you could argue that the KJV copied the Douay Rheims. This is the English Standard Version that just came out. Let's see when it came out. Golly, these people. 2001, 10 years ago. Look at this. For obedience? No. Because of the obedience of Jesus Christ, not to. So all the scholars who were involved in translating this verse, they ought to just get their degrees revoked. Whose obedience is it? See, this is why I keep harping on mistranslation. Okay, I'm sorry, but it's a political football. If somebody else translated it that way before, well, forget what the Bible actually says. We're just going to copy what some men who made a mistake say, so that we fit in with people rather than God. I'm sorry, I'm really losing it. You know, hello. Let's do this one more time. So you know what the Greek says in case somebody says something to you. Kata, according to. Proegnosin, the foreknowledge. Deo, of God. Patros, the Father. En, by means of. In or by means of, but it's really by means of here. Hagiasmoi, the sanctifying work. Pneumatos, of the Spirit. Eis, because of, with reference to, resulting in, or resulting from. Opakoin, yeah, okay, obedience really means standing under hearing. Kai, even. Rantismon, sprinkling means atoning. It's a picturesque word for atonement. Atoning. Chaimatos, blood of who? The hupakoin, the obedience, even the atoning work of the blood of who? Jesus Christ, Jesu Christu. And because of that, charis, grace, homin, to you, kai, even, irene, peace, prosperity, pletunte, be yours in the fullest measure is a good enough translation. See, you wouldn't have grace, and you wouldn't have prosperity, and you wouldn't have peace to the fullest measure if it weren't for, because of, the obedience of, even the atoning blood of Jesus Christ. Now you know the correct translation. So in the future, when you're reading the Bible in translation and you see some dippy thing like this, to obey him and be sprinkled with his blood? Oh, really? When you see something that's completely out of, you know, completely wacko, like that, then you know, oops, there's a mistranslation. So I need to find somebody who knows the Greek or go learn it myself. Go learn it yourself. It's not hard. Did you learn how to, you know, the names of characters in a movie you watched? When you watched Matrix for the first time, didn't you have to learn who Neo was? Okay, well, if you can learn the character names in movies, you can learn the Greek and Hebrew. It's that hard. Bye.